Howdy, folks. Welcome to this week's Ag Report. So this week, I'm going to tell you a little bit about agritainment. That may be a word that you've heard before. Don't ask me to spell it. It may be a new word to you. But basically, what agritainment is that is where a farm or a ranch or some kind of agriculture business opens their door, and it becomes for the public, maybe a form of entertainment in there. So it's kind of a blend. What that may look like to you is you have noticed in the last several years, Christmas tree farms opening up to where you can come in and cut, and they may have hay rides or other things like that, or pumpkin growers open a pumpkin patch, that kind of stuff. So those are kind of forms of agritainment. So I was going to tell you about our personal story of agritainment. Back in 2004 and 2005, my wife and I, Heather, we had a corn maze. So what we did, and I'll go back to necessity is the mother of invention, okay? We were having a rough year in 2004 with prices and dry weather, things like that. And we had a corn crop, that was not looking very good. And, we were trying to figure out, it's kind of like what they say, you see the handwriting on the wall. We knew from lack of rainfall, things like that, that harvest was not going to be very good that fall. And that times were going to be tough. So we were trying to be proactive and do what we could with what we had. Like they say, make lemons out of lemonade. So that's exactly the idea that my wife came up with. She says, you know, we've got this corn growing out there, and it's not going to produce income in the normal way with grain to sell. So we have been advocating for agriculture for many, many years, long before this corn maze came about. We had been talking in schools and things like that, and sharing our story of agriculture and asking questions answering questions for those that want to know, you know, what goes on in ag. So that was nothing new for us. So Heather said, you know what, let's take that corn that's growing out there and let's make a corn maze. She had read about some of those up in the Midwest going on. And so that's what we did. Now, let me explain a little bit. Our first maze was 12 acres. Okay. So that would be a little bit more than 12 football fields in size. Now, remember, we're talking about 2004. So there are no drones, I don't even know if Google Earth was around, that kind of stuff, okay? There's no GPS programs to where you can just walk around and with a handheld thing or anything like that. So what she did is she came up with a design. And the intent is, just like any maze, one way in and one way out, with a whole lot of dead ends and wrong turns in between. That's what makes it fun. And so we did an agriculture-themed design. The first one we did was a tractor and a barn and things like that. But something that we did that was unique is we would take some of my old clothes and make scarecrows out of them. And Heather would put agriculture questions on the scarecrow. And so one of them was like, does chocolate milk come from brown cows? That would be the question. And if you answered yes, there would be an arrow pointing this way. Or if you answered no, you know, if that was your answer, there would be an arrow pointing that away. Well, if you chose no and you followed that arrow, it would lead you in a few minutes to a dead end. And you figured out, oh, that was the wrong answer. So we used it as a form of education. You had to get the right answers to our ag questions to find your way back out of it. So let me explain how we cut or designed that.